Hello, hello, hello. And today I have another episode of the Handmaid's Tale, episode 10. The most depressing episode to date. This is the inaugural. So let's get into this episode. So the episode started with Emily, with her, I don't know what ceremony it was called, the show, whatever, the raping ceremony, with her commander. And a commander, when he's finished, he gets a heart attack. She takes the opportunity to stamp him off on his balls and everything. Anyhow, so they go on to the next scene here with Offred. She's in the market, you know, having two weekly market stuff. And she's telling Emily that, you know, they still have hope because they have a son and a wife in Canada and probably will be able to see them again, you know. And Emily's like, I don't have no son, I don't have no wife. You know, she's giving up at this point, as I would be. If they take my clitoris, I will give up, okay? And then you see Nick's wife is being a little flirty with the wicked dad. Remember the guy from the next episode, you know? The wicked one who stamped down over in Nicky face. Anyhow, she's there, you know, kind of all flirty with the man. Anyhow, then Offred goes into labor in the market, you know. They reach home and Offred and Nick put on a smile. And there's lovey-dovey thing in front of people. I mean, he wife ID, people in the ambulance ID, everybody riding, walking up the stairs with the hand on the back of her, looking at each other and smiling. Anyhow, then Selena is like by the door and Selena goes on her knees and quoting Bible for the baby. Oh my God, this woman is so obsessed with making a baby. She'll do anything at this point. Then, you know, they show the ceremony where, I guess they call it a built-in ceremony, I don't know. Where you see June getting ready in one room and Serena getting ready in one room. Like it's she and labor, you know, doing mimicking the labor, walking, holding your baby, and saying what you're going to do. Bet you're not in labor? Oh, God. Anyhow, it turned out to be Braxton Hicks as his forced labor. And then when they get the whole contract and everything, where your cervix still at 0%, 0 inches wide. And Serena now, she wants to induce labor. She asked the doctor to induce labor. And you know, the doctor say only within the next 2 weeks if she doesn't deliver, he will induce labor. He's not going to induce labor now. And Serena is like, Serena wants to get her out of the house, you know. And Julie is like giving Serena a back chat and thing in front of that woman. I mean, she just watched her and shakes her head, you know. At this point, I believe that she's just leaving June to do whatever she wants. Because, you know, it's labor and she's pregnant with her. But so if June, when they don't make that baby, that woman might have it all clear. Even though we did see a little soft heart from her, but last week, but that woman might have it all clear. Anyhow, so then June, she goes to meet the commander in his office, right? And she's there to ask the commander that, you know, I know I have to leave when I don't make me leave. Could you please put me in the same district with my daughters? And the commander is like, no. I mean, you're always asking for something. You're too lenient and you're always giving you something. Get out. Get out of my office. And June get mad. June spin around and tell him, you'll never know what it's like to be a parent when you have no children. And she give him the last little dig and tell him, and you will never be a father. So that is like confirming to him that child that June is carrying is not his own. So now Serena and the commander is in her little garden, plotting to induce labor the natural way, which we all know is sex. So she called Offred into her room, and then she and the commander proceed to hold on to you and rape you. This bitch, Serena. You know, last, you know, before, not last week, the week before that, I was feeling sorry for her. When he came and I take his belt out and beat she like she was a little child. Okay? But no, Serena, nobody gonna feel sorry for her. The little inkling of Serena is that people are feeling very gone. Or you go hold on a pregnant woman who went to the baby and let the husband push his stink nasty thing inside that shit. Anyhow, now the young girl, okay, is the next wife. And she and his girl has something and she see the girl outside and kiss the girl and Nick sees them and she run upstairs and gone on her knees and start quoting Bible, Gideon Bible scripture. And Nick then's like, doesn't matter, you're not going to get in trouble, whatever. You know, she's actually upset that Nick is not, you know, being mad or punishing her. You know, I mean, this young girl crazy. And you know, only hormones raising and everyone, she hormones raging. You know, she's looking for a man. Anyhow, she's like, is the handmaiden new? Like the handmaiden is crying and getting all of it. And Nick is like, you know that it's suicide, me and I mean, yes, Nick, I hope you know that it's suicide. I hope for sure you know that's suicide. So the next morning, all the commander feeling bad for you. So tell, go up to our friend room and tell her that you have a surprise. Our friend is like in a daze at this moment, you know, heavily pregnant and raped. She's in a daze at this moment. So she goes out to the car and Nick is continually asking her on the way to wherever she goes. If she's okay, she's okay, she's not answering. So they reach to the house and there is her daughter. But this is the most heartbreaking scene because when the daughter now, when the daughter saw her, the daughter ran away behind her and her mother. And then after they eventually kept hugging and everything, when the daughter died only like 10 more minutes and whatever. So then they leave. And then when they leave now, well, you know, June breaks down in the snow and she's crying, distraught, of course, as any mother would be. And then they hear a vehicle approaching and then they run inside the house and then Nick goes outside to try and explain to them that his commander sent them to the house to check on him somewhere. I don't believe it. Now there's a gunshot. Now I don't know if Nick was shot. I don't know if they just handcuffed him up in the minivan. But June is hiding in the house and they take Nick away and take Nick van. And June is left in the middle of nowhere in a snowy place by herself, heavily pregnant. Lil probably messed up in the mind after all that she went through in the last 24 hours. I mean, not in the last year of being in that godforsaken place. So, we have to wait next week to see what's going to happen. And I want to thank you for watching this video straight to the end. And just smile. Good night.